Dear students, a warm welcome to my lecture under Geography, 3rd year BA, Semester 5. The code of the paper is GC105, Physical Geography. Today we are going to discuss about formation and classification of rocks. The outline of my lecture is Earth and its composition, meaning of rocks and minerals, difference between rocks and minerals, and classification of rocks. At the end of the session, students will be able to explain the composition of earth, understand the meaning of rock and mineral, differentiate between rock and mineral, and at the end, they will be able to classify rocks. Earth, the only planet where life is formed, is composed of more than 118 elements. It is very interesting to note that out of 118 elements, only 8 elements make 99.09% of the earth, whereas 110 elements less than 1% of the earth. These are 8 important elements of which earth is composed of: oxygen, silicon, aluminium, iron, calcium, sodium, magnesium, and potassium. Oxygen accounts for 46.1% of the earth. Silicon makes about 28.2% of the earth, whereas aluminium make 8.23%, iron about 5.36%, calcium about 4.15%, sodium 2.36%, magnesium 2.33%, and potassium 2.03%. Sorry, 2.09%. So this entire thing makes about 99.0% of the total earth. So when one or more element come together, they make what is called as a substance. And these substances have certain chemical composition and physical properties. These substances are called minerals. It means minerals are made up of elements. Similarly, when more than one mineral come together, they form what is called a rock. In the sense, minerals are composed of elements and rocks are composed of minerals. Let's have a look at this particular video. Now, this video will give us an idea about how rocks are composed of.
Have you ever looked at a rock and wondered how it came to be? The story begins about 4.5 billion years ago, as gas and dust come together to form the rocks that make up our planet. Created from elements forged far off in a galaxy, rocks really are the stuff of stars. And so are we. Rocks, and the minerals they're made of, tell us the story of our planet. Look closely. Atoms are the building blocks of all matter. Combined, atoms form molecules. Minerals are made up of billions of molecules, which are often arranged in crystal structures. Minerals can crystallize from semi-molten rock called magma.
Rock is a hard material which is composed of one or more minerals, which is already told to you. Rocks are found in the outer crust of the earth, and when these rocks break, decompose or disintegrate, they turn into soil. Meaning, rock is the parent material for the formation of soil. So hence, there is a relationship between soil, rock, minerals and elements. And ultimately, in a soil, what we find is elements, and same thing with rocks and also minerals. Now, rocks can be hard and they can be soft. Rocks can be as hard as granite and they can be as soft as a chalk. Similarly, rocks can be as big as a basalt or they can be as small as a sand particle. Now look at this particular photograph. This is basalt, very, very, very hard rock. This is a chalk, very soft in nature. Similarly, this is a basalt hill or basalt mountain. This entire mountain is composed of one single rock, that is basalt. Whereas from this, you can take one sand particle and that sand particle can also become a rock. So in the sense, a rock can be as small as a sand particle, or it can be as big as this entire hill, or it can be as hard as a granite, or it can be as soft as a chalk. Rocks have been formed of about 2000 different minerals, but most of the rocks are composed of six minerals, namely feldspar, quartz, pyrozines, amphiboles, mica and olivine. Look at this particular picture. This is mica, a very economically significant mineral. Once upon a time, this mineral was used in electrical and electronic industry. It's very, very valuable mineral. So in every rock, you find mica. Similarly, feldspar, quartz, very common mineral. The shining part in a rock is many a times because of quartz, pyrozine, amphiboles, olivine. So these are very important minerals. Those are found in any rock. Let's come to the classification of rocks. Rocks are classified on the basis of their origin. Broadly, we classify them into three types: igneous rocks, which are called primary rocks; sedimentary rocks, which are called secondary rocks; metamorphic rocks, which are called tertiary rocks. Igneous rocks are those rocks which are born due to solidification of lava. Sedimentary rocks are born due to sedimentation of the eroded rocks. And metamorphic rocks are those rocks which are born at a depth due to heat and pressure. In the next lecture, we will be able to understand each one of these rocks